I am Miranda Curtis, and this is my story.
I'll tell you a story.
This project is special because it is the most vulnerable I've been musically. And I've never grieved and created a project before. So this is the result of everything that I felt. The root of that grief was my mother dying on March 19th, 2019. Unexpected. She was always known to be a fighter. And honestly, none of us saw it coming. It caught us off guard. And that's a pain that I still can't form words to describe. She died in March of 2019. I didn't grieve her until June 4th, 2019, to be exact. I'm known for doing my annual birthday photo shoots, and that year I was turning 40. And we decided to go to Death Valley, California to do the photo shoot. In the middle of the photo shoot, I started grieving her. And it wasn't until I left Death Valley that I was inspired to be musical and to even write again. And that's when the journey began. I've never done a project and attached actual scripture on the artwork. I thought it would be great to do that because the subject isn't popular. When you talk about death, I wanted to make sure that I was clear on what these songs meant and the root of the songs to give it a biblical meaning. And I wanted the listener to be able to attach it. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And I wanted to give the listener a map to follow so they could know where they were going. I want them to know and understand that there's a Savior they can run to. I want them to know and understand that it's okay to grieve. It's okay to share with the Lord your feelings. How else are we going to lay what we feel on the altar? It's my desire for the listener to understand that death is a part of life, and death is necessary in order for there to be a resurrection. There has to be a death. My personal experience of dying to live consisted of recognizing my reality. This is the most realistic journey I've ever been on. Death, pandemic. Again, it don't get no realer than that. So I've had to accept that this was my reality. Dying to myself, it consisted of tears, anger, disappointment, all of those things. It took a turn when I realized that it was okay. It was okay to express myself. It was okay to say to the Lord, this ain't fair. It was okay to say to the Lord, this ain't right. We were taught to say, hey, you don't question God, or you don't supposed to be ungrateful to who he is. To who he is an offense to God. And I found out that it was okay to say, I'm angry and I'm frustrated and I'm irritated and I don't know what to do. When I realized that there was nowhere else to turn, like it was nothing else that I could do, that was Jesus standing right there with open arms, saying, all of that you feel, Miranda, all of that you're feeling right now, the only thing I need you to do is trust me with it. And trust me with this journey. Trust me with your pain. Trust me with your feelings. Trust me with your disappointments. Trust me with your questions. Trust me with all of these things. And when I did it, that's when my process began. I need to let y'all in on something. This thing is a process. When you lose a loved one, when people go on with their lives, it's a process. I can't say that I'm healed. But what I can say is, although I am wounded, I can still declare healing at the same time. The beauty of all of this is I'm able to declare and do both. I can be wounded and still declare that he's Rapha. I can be wounded and still say that he's able. I can be wounded and still say that he's faithful. I can be wounded and say that he supplies all of my needs still. So it's a journey. It's a journey. I don't have a book. I don't have that kind of solution. I don't have the answers. All I've had is time. Time. Grief comes in waves. But I was determined to keep moving. The valley was designed for us to go through it, not stay there. So that's the revelation that I got. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow, through, it was designed for us to go through it. And I'm grateful that I didn't stop. I may have gotten winded. I may have slowed down, but I didn't stop. So I encourage you that if you're in this place, don't stop. Keep moving. You don't have to move at everyone else's pace, but keep moving. Don't pitch a tent. Don't build a house in the valley. It was not designed for you to stay there. Keep moving. And that's what die to live means. Discipline. Denying yourself in exchange for an abundant life. Anxiety died, it was put to death, and trust was resurrected. Doubt was put to death. Truth was resurrected. Restlessness was put to death. Peace was resurrected. Don't mistake these tears as sadness. This is strength. Weakness died, and strength lived. It was resurrected. So the name of this album is called Die to Live. It is a different one, different body of work, y'all. But I believe that it's going to help so many people. I believe it's going to free so many people. I am encouraged. I'm excited for the listener to hear. I can't wait to see the manifestations of what God is going to do in your lives. I pray that when you hear the songs, that your faith is renewed, that your hope is restored. I am Miranda Curtis, and this is my story. I hope you enjoy the journey.